Paris. A late November night. And it hadn't stopped raining for 3 days. Through my studio window, I watched the dark silhouette of an exhausted dog. Its slow stride revealed its old age. To the left stood a container full of garbage. I could catch a glimpse of my latest painting in the depths of my studio. I watched it silently. It was worn out and without soul. My dear child, today is November the 6th, 1996. This morning I touched for the very first time the tomb of Jesus Christ and wept for the soul of my mother, of my father, and of all poor souls. The Son of God, crucified and eternal, was above me on the cross. It seemed that the pain of Golgotha hovered above the candle smoke. Then I passed by the Wailing Wall, and the scent of eternity was in the Jerusalem air. I was long haunted by the great soul of this lonely old woman. I can feel her presence close to me, like the gentle mother of all mothers. Paris. Several years had gone by. One night, I was wandering from bar to bar. It was August. The streets were deserted, and nothing was happening. When I returned to my studio, I had no wish to do anything. There was not enough breathing space. It was filled with things. I began to look for some space to begin painting. But I couldn't see it. I became depressed. I was distraught. And I hated myself from the depths of my soul. Obsessed with time. I tried to understand time. I tried to caress it. I imagined it as a prince who was now on a ship, now in a desert, now on a cloud. Then I watched how it ran on for years, on and across different crossroads. Through the archives of my memory, I wanted to reach the freedom of its omnipotence. And I still keep traveling and trying to reach the universe of its freedom. But time begins once again to drift away.